Some people think that models and TV stars have amazing, perfect bodies because they're just born that way. Tell me what you think about that.
I think that's absolutely absurd. Any woman past the age of 24, 25 knows that you don't get it for free anymore. I am pretty much the last Mohicans in my family when it comes to being in shape. They're always telling me to, you know, gain a little bit more weight, but I'm looking at them and I'm like, ooh, you want to just give me some of yours? So I think there's a big, bad misconception that people in Hollywood don't do anything but drink mojitos next to a pool and get this fabulous figure. But they're getting it, be it in a healthy way or an unhealthy way. They're doing something for it. It just doesn't happen that way.
Now, outside of drinking mojitos and laying by the pool, how often would you say that you work out and how much?
I work out in a good week, all 7 days. I work out a good hour or two a day. Mostly my workouts are cardio-based.
With all the time that you spend working out, you must really love it.
I do really love it. I love it to the point of almost obsession, and my obsession is finding all those workouts that benefit me the most, that give back to me the most. I don't want to waste my time on anything, and that is why I'm so happy I found the Flex Belt, because it's A, not a waste of my time, and B, gives me the results.
What do you find is the toughest part of your body to keep in shape?
For me, it's definitely my core. My core, it's so hard. It's hard to stay motivated. It's hard to keep the willpower once I did get the motivation to get through my workouts. And with the Flex Belt, it tightens, it tones, and it strengthens without me having to think about it. I mean, it's taken my ab workout to a whole nother level.
What is the Flex Belt gonna do for women out there?
What it's gonna do for women, especially a woman like me who's already in shape, already has things going, all women have this little pooch right around their belly button. And for me and for most women, it hits that area that we can sit at the gym all day. Hitting your lower abs is not only incredibly difficult, that's the harder ab workout. The upper abs are easy. The lower ones are really hard. And to get to the motivation to sweat and go through this grueling workout is very hard. And with the Flex Belt, you don't need that motivation. You strap it on and it hits the area that is the hardest to hit easily with a press of a button.
So no matter how busy you are, how crazy your schedule gets, how lazy you're feeling, you can always get a great ab workout in with the Flex Belt.
Absolutely. I can take that thing anywhere. It's incredibly portable. It's not like some huge fitness device. It's something that I don't have to put thought into. Nobody has to know what's going on. There's really no excuse not to wear it. I could go to a pitch meeting in a major network with it on. I can handle phone meetings with it on. I can handle my hobbies, which is video games. I can make dinner, I can do the laundry, I can talk to my mom, and maybe ignore half of what she's saying. You know, all this stuff is possible, you know, with the Flex Belt, but without it, you can't do anything but your abs. That's your main focus.
Can the Flex Belt really compare to the type of core workouts you do on your own?
For me, my core workouts are normally 3 days a week, and I'm so ashamed to admit this, I spend 10 minutes on my core 3 days a week, because I'm spending a lot of time on other places. I'm doing a lot more abs now with the Flex Belt than I was without it, and I see the difference. I can see plain definition between my obliques and my abs, which I didn't have before. I don't know why I'm so lazy with my abs, but I am. And there's something out there to help me continue doing so.
Well, don't be ashamed. It's you and 99% of the planet that hate working their abs.
Yeah, true.
Which is why the Flex Belt is here.
Yes. We're all lazy. Well, abs hurt. They really hurt. And
yes.
The thing with the Flex Belt for me is it doesn't hurt while you're doing it, but you feel the hurt later, and the hurt's good because that means you've done something.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
And most people, when they're working their core, they work their core to that point where they start to feel that burning sensation, and then they stop.
They stop.
And that's exactly when you need to keep going.
Yeah, and a lot of ab workouts that I see, I'll walk around the gym, there's a lot of people doing in proper form.
Right. That's the beautiful part about the Flex Belt as well, is that there's no guesswork mm-hmm. with it. right? As like you mentioned, most people doing their abs do them completely wrong.
So wrong.
So no benefit whatsoever. Yeah. Put the flex belt on, you don't have to worry about it. You know it's gonna work. You know it's gonna do the things that you need to do, right?
Hopefully I'm gonna have, for the first time in my life, a full on six pack. I've got the four pack with a hint of five and six.
Yeah.
But that's the farthest I've ever been. So I'm very happy right now, yes.
Adrianne, with all the machines that you have available to you at the gym, at your home, people probably throwing workout equipment your way to try out. Why use the flex belt?
The flex belt is a lot more convenient than having to focus on getting on the floor and doing things. Most people that know me know I have a slight focus problem. If I'm not running and doing things, I lose focus. And with the flex belt, I can put it on, lose my focus, forget it's even there except for a couple times like, ooh, that was a good one, and do everything that I have to do. And I don't have to really focus on it. And that's a beautiful thing.
Now, tell me about the first time you tried it.
I was very surprised at what a hard crunch that I got initially, just my first crunch. It almost took the breath out of me because I wasn't prepared for it to be that good.
Now, did you feel it just in your upper abs, in your lower ab? Where did you feel it the most?
Because of where the sensors are located, and because of how big the middle sensor is, the middle sensor got my lowest abs. Like, I'm talking, like, down abs, and then on the top as well. And then the sides were contracting my obliques, so it was literally like my whole stomach was going in and then coming out. Going in, coming out. And it was fascinating to watch it do it.
So it was contracting every area in your whole core at the same time?
Every area in my core at the same time.
Did you know the Flex Belt was the first product of its kind to be cleared by the FDA?
I did know that, and that is incredibly important because that tells me that I can trust it.
Now, if you have back problems and you hate getting on the floor, because for the majority of core exercises, you have to get down on the floor. And like you mentioned before, working your lower core especially is not only difficult, but it hurts. Mm-hmm. And it hurts the majority of people in their lower back. Now, how is the Flex Belt gonna be beneficial to those individuals?
I think the Flex Belt is gonna be incredibly beneficial to these people. I mean, I don't even have a bad back, but to work my lower abs, it hurts my back. Like, it's not comfortable, it's really straining. With the Flex Belt, you're not strained. You can sit on the couch, you can lay down, you can read a book, you could go to the beach. I mean, you could do all these things without having to strain the rest of your body.
The beautiful thing about the Flex Belt is anyone can use it. You put it on, you set the power controller to your desired intensity level. You don't need willpower, you don't need motivation. Just put it on and get started right away.
Absolutely, there's no reason anymore for any excuses from anybody. I mean, you put on the Flex Belt, it does all the work for you, and you get all the results. Can't complain.